Hi, so today we will learn how to make a CV in Overleaf, which is a LaTeX open source software. So first you have to make an account. I already have one, so I can go ahead. Templates are already available to choose and put your information. So we will go to templates. There are many types of templates you can pick from, such as you can make a research article, you can also write a book, CV, make a poster, a newsletter, presentation, and thesis, and so on. So here today in this video, we will focus on making a CV using Overleaf. There are many templates to choose from. You can choose the one you like. I will choose the Prometheus CV. If you chose the template you like, just click on Open as Template. Then a new window will appear where you will see your template. Then it will consist of three sections. The one which consists the main files, the second the code in which you can edit the code according to your own information, and third the visualization and the PDF where will you see the changes and the PDF which you can download later. First we will see that there is one main file in which you can make the changes. It consists of various sections, such as the first is on education, then publications, honors, skills, and services. So you can add and delete the section which you want. For example, I don't want to add extracurricular activity. So I will just go to the main file and select the section I don't need, select it and delete it. When I click on recompile, you can see that it's deleted from the main file also. If you want, you can delete the main the file from here, or you can let it be for maybe for your future reference. So we will go here. We have different sections like education, we have honors, publication, and so on. So first we'll go to the title file. I don't want this line, so I will just select this and delete it. Then here is the name, so I'll change this to my name. And next is the keywords. You can see there are a few keywords, maybe the research interest of yours, so you can add those and change it to my research interest. That is text mining, second is on machine learning, quality communication. Go to recompile and click it, then you will see the changes made in your code file over here, right? Then they are still showing some few more keywords and I don't need it, so I'll just select those and delete it. So next, showing some links to the, such as the website link, your email, your phone number, LinkedIn, and Google Scholar. So you can make those changes over here. If you don't have a website, you can delete it. Then second is your email address. So you can put over here, mail to your email address. It will show like that. Third is your phone number. If you don't want it, you can just select it and delete it. And then your LinkedIn profile, and then your Google Scholar profile you can put over here. You can see I deleted the phone number and the website. It's just the email address, LinkedIn, and the Google Scholar profile. Next is the education file. So I'll go to the education file. Over here is some year. So I can put 2009 to 2012. You can put your school name, university name over here. Then your course which you did, then you can again over here you can see you can give a description about what you did, or you can just leave the section over here. So if I don't want it, I just select it and delete it. Then you can put another information over here, or you can just select and delete it. Then you compile. So once it's compiled, you can see the changes over here. Education is done. Next is publication. So if you have any publication, you can go to the publication file and put the name, your details over here. If you don't have, you can just delete this section. The next one is the honors. So if you have any honors, like in 2012, from University of Delhi, got travel scholarship. So you can put such honors or scholarships and awards over here. If you want to change from honors to honors and scholarship or honors and awards, you can go to the main file, text file, And over here, instead of honors, you can write honors and awards and save it. So then you will see the changes in your main PDF. There is change to honors and awards. Okay, the honors I just changed over here, and I can delete the rest if I want and save it, and can see the changes over here. Next is the skills. If you want, you can add some skills. So you can even put numbers. So you, for that, you have to write begin, enumerate, okay, and you can add the items over here. Click on compile, recompile, then you can see the changes over here. Okay, if you want, instead of the numbers, you want bullet points. So instead of enumerate, you just write itemize. Okay, and close it with itemize. Then if you again click on recompile, you will see the changes. It becomes bullets, okay? If you want to bold some of the facts, like you want to bold R, okay, so then you have to, in front of R, you have to write text BS and put in the brackets and save it. You will see that the R is now bold. If you want to italicize Microsoft Office, put slash EMPF and put in the word which you want to italicize in the brackets. Then recompile. You will see the changes in your PDF file. Now it became italicized. Okay. Now next is your services to the scientific community. For that, go to the service file. So first is what service you did. Here I will put a year, like 2012. Here I will put reviewing. Then here I can put the journal name, okay, for example, journal of big data. So when I will save it, I'll see the changes and delete the extra columns and save it. If you want to add some new column, for that you just have to add one file. So here, add a new file, give a name. For example, you want to add about workshops you attended, and create a new file. Then go to that file and paste in your workshop one. And here just change it a year, like in 2019, you attended the workshop on web programming from where, for example, you did online or virtual, University of Delhi, okay, then you can just save it. Won't show it right. To show, you have to go to the main file and add that section over here, right, like the others. And where you want to put it, you want to put it in the end or in between. Maybe I want to put it after publication, okay? So I'll go here after publication. I'll just add in section of workshops. Section, workshops attended. And then input the file names. So it's case sensitive, so please take care about that. And then just save it. So now you will see that it will come after publication, the workshop section, workshops attended. You can change the file name, so when it downloads, you can see that your names, this is your file name now. Again, recompile it. If you are satisfied with all the changes, you can now download your PDF. So once it's downloaded, you will see that the top it will be written your name, okay? And then you can see all the changes you made. So this is a short video of how to create CV in Overleaf. Thanks for watching. Hope you liked the video.